fellow scientists, it's Justin again, and welcome back to another installment of Science in the Real World. In this unit, we've learned all about plants, animals, and the amazing adaptations that help them survive. Now, what has always set humans apart from these other forms of life is our extreme intelligence. But we may have more to learn from nature than we think. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to explain how studying the structures and adaptations of nature can lead to solutions for human challenges. Let's get into it! Humans are really good at finding solutions to problems. Some may even say problem solving is one of our best adaptations. But we don't always come up with those solutions on our own. Sometimes we take our inspiration from nature. Biomimicry is the practice of designing solutions by copying nature. Humans do this in a few different ways: copying nature's shapes, its behaviors, or its systems. Imagine you're peacefully asleep. It's Saturday morning, and you have nowhere to be. When suddenly, BOOM! An earth-shattering noise rips you from your slumber. This was a problem in Japan, where bullet trains can travel up to 200 miles per hour. That's very cool, but those crazy fast speeds had a big downside. The extreme force of a bullet train exiting a tunnel could produce a sonic boom. The solution to this problem came from an unexpected place. A member of the engineering team was a bird watcher. While bird watching, he observed a kingfisher, that's this bird here, diving into the water to catch a fish. He noticed that despite its speed, the kingfisher hardly made a splash. Watch the kingfisher dive for yourself. What do you think allows the bird to enter the water so smoothly? Record your thoughts in your guided notes. So the engineers redesigned their trains, like this. Which part of the bird do you think inspired them? Exactly, its beak. They changed the shape of the trains to be long and streamlined, just like the kingfisher's beak. The results were astounding. Not only did the new design eliminate the noise, but it also made the trains faster and more energy efficient. By observing the natural world, engineers solved a major problem and improved their technology. This isn't the only time nature has given us great ideas. Taking inspiration from the shapes of nature is becoming more and more common. For instance, what do you think of when you hear this sound? Way back in the 1940s, a Swiss engineer went for a hike in the woods with his dog. After the walk, he noticed burrs stuck all over his clothes and his dog. Curious, he examined them under a microscope and discovered they were covered in tiny hooks that latched onto the loops in fabric and fur. This inspired him to create a fastening system that mimicked the burrs. He designed one side with tiny hooks and the other side with tiny loops, and Velcro was born. This invention revolutionized how we fasten things, from shoes to spacesuits. Inventions inspired by the shapes of nature are everywhere if you know where to look. But biomimicry doesn't only copy shapes. We know that animals don't only have physical adaptations to help them survive. They have behavioral ones too, such as hibernation and migration. We can look to these behaviors and strategies to help us solve problems. For example, one problem people have looked to biomimicry to solve is in dealing with tsunamis. A tsunami is a giant, dangerous wave caused by underwater earthquakes. To warn people that a tsunami may be coming, sensors are placed deep underwater to detect earthquakes. Getting information from the sensor to the people on land can be tricky, though. It has to travel long distances through water and fast. Can you think of any animals that communicate through water? Dolphins have the ability to communicate with each other using ultrasonic chirps. These chirps travel through water extremely quickly, which is why scientists are developing short laser pulses that mimic dolphin chirps for tsunami warning systems. But that's not the only problem biomimicry is helping to solve. Another big challenge we face as self-driving cars become more common is navigating them safely and avoiding traffic congestion. Have you ever been stuck in a traffic jam and wondered if there was a better way? Well, one of nature's smallest creatures might have an answer. Ants are extremely good at working together to find the most efficient path to travel. They leave behind chemical signals to guide other ants to food or back to the nest. This efficient communication helps them avoid obstacles and reduce congestion. Scientists took inspiration from this ant behavior to improve the way self-driving cars navigate. They programmed the cars to talk to each other, sharing information about traffic conditions and obstacles in real time. By doing this, they can adjust their routes to avoid traffic jams and accidents, much like ants finding the best path to food. This results in smoother traffic flow, reduced congestion, and safer roads. Imitating behaviors found in nature has been incredibly useful, but there's another way humans solve problems by looking to nature, by mimicking its systems. Ecosystems in nature are extremely efficient, with each organism playing a crucial role within its system. By observing these natural systems, we can learn how to create sustainable and efficient solutions for human challenges on a large scale. That's what cities like Lavasa, India are doing. Lavasa was designed to mimic a forest ecosystem. The city's rooftops are inspired by the native banyan fig leaf, whose pointed shape causes water to run off it quickly. To prevent floods, the city took inspiration from local harvester ants, building multi-path shallow channels to divert water away. Even the foundations of the buildings have been designed like tree roots to store water. By incorporating these natural principles, Lavasa runs with the efficiency of an ecosystem. With its shapes, behaviors, and systems, nature provides endless inspiration for solving human challenges. Let's review everything we've learned today. Biomimicry is the practice of designing solutions to human problems by copying nature. This can be done by mimicking shapes found in nature, animal behaviors, or whole ecosystems. To review everything we've learned in this unit, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. Seeing how helpful biomimicry is makes it clear to me how important it is to study the structures of life. What would you copy from nature? Remember, scientists, curiosity is the architect of discovery. See you next time! Hey.